Blocker lovers, your weekly art news is here. This time, I bring you the latest cross-artistic expressions collaboration that just happened in Peru. Plus, the largest art residencies database. But first things first, let's think outside the block. Here we come with international news. Our dear collaborator in Berlin, Helena Herzberg, aka our Editora, brings a super special from the opening show of Peruvian artist Lucas Rueckner. You ready?
Now, giving you an exclusive look into the latest art show by Peruvian artist Lucas Rueckner. Last Friday, the exhibition opened at the art residency Backsteinboot in Berlin, Germany. Located on an island in the tranquil Spandau district, the opening welcomed artists and friends from all over the city. The show is titled Maria Luque and shows a collection of his Berlin-inspired works that he has produced since his arrival 3 years ago. Before, he lived and studied in Lima, Peru, and is now continuing an in-depth exploration of his creative impulses and productions through a master in art therapy. Summarizing the raw quality that is or makes the artist, the sculptures, paintings, drawings, and installations represent the creative space that exists between his memory, imagination, and reality. With an explosive color palette and quirky humor, each work of art seems to emote a personality of its own. Perhaps the artist was inspired by the colorful array of people that inhabit the city of Berlin. After all, Rueckner has commented before that his pursuit for the ideal creative haven ended in the German capital, a place that is riddled with distractions and yields plenty of experiences to inspire his impulsive creative process. Maria Luque is a dedication to a family member that he holds dear. It is a show of appreciation and celebration and invites the speculative eye to explore and play with the three-dimensionality of his works. How far does your imagination reach?
Danke schön, Helena. I'm so glad you got the chance to meet him and familiarize with his art pieces. Next week, prepare because we'll have a super hot exclusive view from Art Editora at the Ayoy Kusama's exhibit in Germany. So follow both accounts and you won't miss this. More news! Artists, are you looking for art residencies? Well, let me share what I just found a couple of days ago, and it's just a click away. A huge Google Doc of everything you need to find it. Everest Pipkin's Big Artist Opportunities List is a shared Google Doc with tons of information on residencies, grants, and more. Damn, I freaking love true collaborations as this keeps growing and growing. Thank you, Powerhouse Everest Pipkin. My love to you all the way from Peru. Now, if you are interested in more juicy art residencies and tips, join me in a casual convo on Clubhouse on Tuesday 22, 7 p.m. GMT minus 5, right next to my girl Jess Gamble from Philly. You ask for more, here is more. The Center Pompidou will have a U.S. outpost in Jersey City on 2024. Yes, the Satellite Museum will host exhibitions drawn from the Paris Institution's 120,000 strong collection of modern and contemporary art. It was announced last Friday. As well as exhibiting art from the Centre Pompidou's vast collection, which comprises masterpieces by artists such as Frida Kahlo, Joan Miró, Henri Matisse, and Marcel Duchamp, the outpost will also host cultural events and educational programs. The opening will take place a year after the Centre Pompidou in Paris shuts for extensive maintenance work that the French government says will continue until 2026. It seems that's the best answer for not having profits during 1 year. We'll see how this maintenance ends up. Don't forget, BLOC Art is the local art portfolio that represents 40 Latin American artists, which 30 are from Peru. Yes, where Machu Picchu is located and Lima is recognized as one of the food capitals in the world. Well, we also have a very wide offer of talented artists from different regions of the entire country. So don't be shy and ask for our artist portfolios. We got one last free shipping to the USA. Side note, our platform believes in the true power of the arts and won't ever ally with a specific ideology or political party. As one of the most illuminated scientists said, if your hate could be turned into electricity, it would light up the whole world. don't hesitate, don't even doubt about transforming your hate into energy and determination. It is possible, but discern how you want to play and be that change in your community. Now, news from Peru. The latest collaboration with the National Ballet Company and Ministry of Culture, three of our female Peruvian artists, Carmen Reategui, Ivette Salazar, and Claudia Cafarena, were part of the suffrage piece, directed by young choreographer Juan Pablo Rodriguez. The artworks were projected in a 45-foot wall, approximately 14 meters, while the ballerinas were dancing and music started playing, produced by Peruvian living in the Mediterranean, Yves Matin. A true art synergy happened here. You would like to enjoy it? Well, click in the link below as a comment. We're looking to take this piece to different ballet theaters around the globe. So if you think you can help us to achieve that, just send an email to contact@bloc-art.com. Gorgeous subscribers, you get the extra BLOC Art News. News from Peru. Upcoming photographic exhibition will happen at the Central Park of Miraflores District in Lima, Peru, and is all about Huacapiana. Don't worry, virtual exhibition will also happen. So everyone around the globe will connect with the Huacapiana. Huaca means ancient pre-Incan sanctuary. This time, I've invited Liz Hiras, Peruvian artist, who portrays the architecture in the country. But this specific show is celebrating the 40 years of the research project led by archaeologist Isabel Flores and how we, as Limeans, got to recognize and embrace the culture we got in front of our eyes, projected contagiously to everyone surrounding us. Probably you've been to Miraflores District, or maybe in the restaurant, which is inside the Huaca itself. But what else do you know about the amazing construction that gathers so much cultural baggage? Let's open the portals. Plus, a virtual exhibition, as I mentioned before, will be available through ArtSteps platform. Stay tuned. Well, beautiful BLOC Art people, that's all for this week's episode. I'll see you next one with more news. And don't forget, find us on artsy platform as BLOC Art Gallery. Remember, subscribe to our YouTube channel, ring the bell so you don't miss any of our upcoming episodes. Share this video, love each other, and of course, keep safe, be a skeptic, question absolutely everything, and think outside the block.